In a certain valley in mid-Wales, the business of rounding up the sheep is carried on in a manner that would render Phil Drabble speechless. As a variation on One Man and His Dog, at least it's original. But then Billy Fury has always had his own way of doing things. After 10 years of running a farm in the middle of nowhere, he feels that at 41, he's ripe for a comeback in the career he embarked on as a teenager.
When my mates told me I looked a bit like Eddie Cochran, so I immediately went out and bought a guitar, which I didn't play too well. And I used to annoy my father something awful with the... He made out I made a terrible racket, which I did. And I only learned to play... I think it was... I had 3 chords, so I couldn't play the songs I wanted to play. So I decided to... I didn't decide, I kind of made up my own songs.
Don't wait about for me, I don't want it, can you see? Well, I got somebody new, and she ain't me like it.
Billy Fury was one of Britain's first rock and roll stars. But he retired young from the music business to do what he really loves best, looking after animals. He and Lisa, his wife, bought 100 acres near Brecon and surrounded themselves with dogs, sheep and horses. Not bad for a Liverpool boy who'd hardly seen a farm by the time he became famous.
Did you enjoy growing up in Liverpool?
No, I didn't enjoy my childhood very much at all.
Why?
Well, I was a very... I was always sick. I was always in hospital, and doctors, or I was lying in bed somewhere. And I missed a hell of a lot of my schooling. And every time I got back to school, I didn't know the kids. I was a kind of... always the stranger. And I didn't get on with the kids, and I didn't get on with the teachers. I was just glad to leave.
The healthy outdoor life Billy leads conceals a background of almost lifelong illness. Rheumatism and rheumatic fever as a child left him with a damaged heart. And a few years ago, he had to have open heart surgery. But he refuses to live the life of an invalid.
I kind of enjoy fighting against it. My doctor says, don't do it, don't do this, don't do that, and I do it. I do it all the more.
Did you turn to music because of that, do you think?
I think I turned to music because I enjoyed it, number one. Number two, I think I probably dreamed about being a singer, but never thought it would happen. And also because when I was writing my songs, I was kind of alone, and I just enjoyed being alone. I was very much a loner.
Billy was an overnight discovery, literally. One day he was a tugboat hand on the Mersey, the next he was touring in a rock and roll show.
It's all right. La 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 la. La la la. La 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 la. La la la. La 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 la. La la la.
Billy Fury's real name was Ronnie Wycherley. But that didn't have the right ring to it for Larry Parnes, the impresario whose taste in exciting aliases also led him to rechristen Marty Wilde, Dickie Pride, and Vince Eager. Within weeks, Billy was a star. But as he listens now to Halfway to Paradise, his greatest hit of 20 years ago, he's not too impressed.
This is torture. You get your kicks torture.
That's the one people remember of yours most, isn't it?
I'm afraid so, I can't get rid of it.
What do you think when you hear your own records now, your old ones?
Not too much.
I suppose, I mean, you must have made a lot of money in those days.
Yeah.
I mean, did you spend it all, like a lot of people did, or were you careful?
I spent a lot of money to begin with, and then there wasn't really much to spend it on.
So you saved it?
I saved it, I invested. Yeah. Had people invest for me.
I mean, I don't want to sort of pry or anything, but are you comfortably placed?
I think so.
Billy now regularly visits London, either to make a recording himself or to supervise young singers he's discovered. With his producer, Stuart Coleman, Billy spent hours working on the single which marked his comeback.
Second verse.
A new career in music is an unexpected twist in the remarkable life of Billy Fury. But this time, the state of his health and the farm in Wales mean he has no intention of going back to singing full-time.
If the new record's a success, is that going to mean a lot of public appearances?
I don't think so, James. I don't think I've really got that much time, number one. And number two is, I don't think I could take the pace of it anymore. You know, the old pace, do this, do that, do the other, come here, go there. I don't think I can keep it up. But I decided a long, long time ago that I wouldn't go in for children. I had the idea that I was going to pop off a lot shorter earlier on in my life, and I didn't want to leave kids around without a father. I reckon I'm trying to do as much as I possibly can because I spent such a lot of time being laid up with illness. I like to live every day as it comes, as full as possible.